SpaceX recently launched 4 astronauts on a NASA mission to International Space Station, the ISS. But it has now come to light that the astronauts on board the SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft had a near collision with an unidentified object on their way. Hi everyone, what's up guys? DozGeek here with Section 51. So today let's talk about SpaceX. I guess that most of you have seen the recent launch of SpaceX. NASA and Elon Musk's SpaceX launched the 4 astronaut team on a flight to the International Space Station, the ISS, on Friday last week, April the 23rd, without any hitch. The Crew 2 mission took off from the Launch Complex 39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida at 5:49 a.m. ET. The launch was earlier scheduled for Thursday last week but had been delayed due to unfavorable weather conditions. The 4 astronauts on board include NASA's Megan McArthur and Shane Kimbrough, JAXA Akihiko Oshide, and the ESA's Thomas Pesquet, a French guy like me. So the Falcon 9 rocket catapulted the astronauts into space aboard a Crew Dragon capsule early Friday morning, and the Space Junk Street, known as a possible conjunction, was reported around 1:43 p.m. EDT. So several hours after launching, and as the crew was preparing to sleep inside the Dragon crew capsule.
Dragon, SpaceX, for possible conjunction.
Yes, Sarah, go ahead.
For awareness, we have identified a late-breaking possible conjunction with a fairly close miss distance to Dragon. As such, we do need you to immediately proceed with suit donning and securing yourselves in seats. We will be erring on the side of caution to get you guys into a better configuration. The time of closest approach for this event is at
17:43. SpaceX Sarah Gilles told the astronauts to prepare as a safety precaution in case of an impact. So astronauts were advised to wear their pressurized suits by SpaceX as there wasn't enough time for them to get out of the way of the object. The possibility of the conjunction came so close to the closest approach time that there wasn't time to compute and execute a debris avoidance maneuver with confidence.
Copy, Sarah. You want us in the suit for a possible close call of a... Okay, we're getting in the suit and we copy off.
Gilles later radioed an update to the astronauts, saying the debris appeared to be passing Crew Dragon at a farther distance than initially expected. An all clear was given a short time later.
Dragon, SpaceX, for awareness. We believe the object is farther away than anticipated, lower risk of possible conjunction, but please ensure visors are closed and zippers are closed prior to TCA in approximately 20 seconds.
And Sarah, we copy the object is farther than predicted and you want us zippers closed and visors down at this time.
So it is confirmed that the team of astronauts were warned of the potential collision by the US Space Command, and the object tracked has been classified as unknown. On Monday, April the 26th, US Space Command officials said it turns out there was no object and no threat, and the false alarm is now under review. The distance and composition of the debris was not immediately clear, although some reports suggest the UFO was about 45 kilometers away, meaning there wasn't any major and real danger to the astronauts and the spacecraft. I think that astronauts clearly saw the UFO passing near SpaceX. And I have to say that I have a strange feeling hearing about this incident. Of course, we can see on a part of the video some piece of debris moving just after the Crew Dragon capsule is separating from the rocket, and it's moving very fast, but it's very close to the capsule, and I don't think that they were talking about that object as many YouTube channels would like us to believe. Maybe it's a space debris or a debris ejected by the rocket during the separation process. In fact, I think that the real UFO which was announced as a potential threat doesn't appear in the videos. Or if it is visible, maybe it appears in more classified videos, and of course it was supposed to be at a greater distance than what we see in this video. So I think that we don't talk about the same UFO that the one appearing on this video. The one in this video is not the UFO reported by Space Command. I believe that usually the orbit and speed of most trackable junk in space is known and factored into things such as launch decisions and passes of approach to the ISS. So, how did this happen? Certainly, astronauts aboard the space station, about the size of a football field, have several times in the past moved the ISS to avoid getting smacked by one of the millions of pieces of space junk in low Earth orbit. But what if that UFO reported to the crew had some extraterrestrial origins? And why US Space Command rushed to officially say that there was no object and no threat, whereas the astronauts were clearly seeing it? I suppose that they were clearly seeing it. Finally, the Crew Dragon Endeavour successfully docked at the space station early Saturday, April the 24th, but it still remains unclear what the object was, however. And that brings us back to many UFO sightings reported by astronauts while in space during previous missions in the past. For example, during the Gemini 4 mission in June 1965, pilot Jim McDivitt spotted an object that he described as a white cylindrical shape with a white pole sticking out of one corner of it. He took two pictures of it. His partner, Ed White, was asleep at the time. McDivitt maintains that it was some unknown but man-made piece of debris, maybe a part of the Titan II second stage of the craft. Then, in a transcript of Gemini 7 mission in December 1965, the astronauts mention a bogey which ufologists have claimed was a reference to a UFO. Based on their trajectory analysis of the mission, the astronauts' comments about a bogey may be referring to booster-associated debris and not a reference to some sort of UFO. 7-9,
what's clear. 7, go ahead. How close are you with the clock high? This is Houston. Say again, 7.
So we have a bogey at 10 o'clock high.
The astronaut who made the comments, Frank Borman, later confirmed that what he saw was not a UFO. Within the UFO community, stories have spread that Neil Armstrong was reported to have witnessed multiple UFOs during Apollo 11 in 1969. An explanation was that the sightings could have been attributed to technical components. Additional stories were accredited to a hoax spread by science fiction writer Otto Binder. Buzz Aldrin, pilot in Apollo 11 mission, says his words were taken out of context from an interview in 2005 about the incident. And during a 2005 spacewalk outside the International Space Station, astronaut Leroy Chiao reported seeing lights in a formation he described as in a line and almost like an upside-down check mark. The incident was promoted as a possible UFO sighting in the television series Are We Alone? Chiao later identified the lights as being from fishing boats hundreds of miles below. In August 2013, according to NASA TV, astronaut Christopher Cassidy saw a UFO float past the International Space Station near its Progress M-52 cargo ship. It was soon identified by Russian flight controllers as an antenna cover from the Zvezda service module. All these UFO reports seem to be well explained or justified by NASA. But what about the UFO sighting reported by astronaut Major Gordon Cooper in 1963 during his flight in space? A UFO sighting that still remains unexplained today. You can check the video of his story here on the channel. And what about the UFO sighting captured on video by Russian cosmonaut Ivan Wagner aboard the ISS in August 2020? I don't think we can explain everything so simply. I think something very strange happened near SpaceX recently, and I think we are trying to make this incident commonplace. Only the astronauts on board the Dragon capsule know what they saw, or what they didn't see. Maybe some of them will reveal it one day in the future. Maybe SpaceX and Elon Musk are starting now to accumulate information about alien life forms in space in the last few years, thanks to the many rocket launches they did. What would you do if you were Elon Musk? And if you owned pictures or information about UFO sightings in space, would you reveal them to the public? Or would you rather keep them, waiting for the right moment to disclose everything? Maybe by monetizing these informations? That's a businessman after all. As always, you are free to believe what you want, so please, let us know what you think in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video. While waiting for the next video, you can find us on social networks, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Don't forget to activate the bell button in order to be notified every time a new video is published. And if you want to support us, go ahead and check the links below. You will find the link to our merch store. Please like this video, share, subscribe, support Section 51. I'll be back really soon. Open your eyes, watch the sky, live long and prosper.